All right, chapter one. This guy says he's from Geneva, and his family's really distinguished from there. His dad's like super distinguished from that area, and he decided not to get married until much, much later in his life. But he wasn't really looking to get married. So this friend of his named Beaufort is like a really popular guy, and he loses a lot of his money. So rather than being destitute in his home country, he moves to a different country with his daughter. So Beaufort has a daughter named Caroline. So Caroline tries to find a job. She gets one, but she can't make ends meet. So her dad dies. But he dies right before the narrator's father finds her. So the narrator's father takes Caroline back home, and for a couple years he leaves her there with a family member to take care of her, and then he marries her after 2 years. Being that this is his like best friend's daughter, he decided this woman deserves the world. So the two of them kind of just go off on adventures for a long time. And as they're traveling around, eventually she gets knocked up. The narrator was born in Naples, and he's an only child for a long damn time. Travels around with him all over the place. And his mother wants to have a daughter, but they don't really have another kid immediately. They're traveling around a lot. She's content, but she wants to have a daughter. The narrator's dad goes off to Milan for the day, and he and his mom go off to visit this place where there's a bunch of poverty. So they find this place with a bunch of poverty, walk to this house that has 5 hungry children there, and one of them looks real different from the others. She's blonde and cute, and she's like been taken in by this family, but she's not actually belonging to the family. Her mother was German and died in birth, and her father was a nobleman, but she goes along with them instead. They adopt her, and the dad comes home and finds that, well, he's got a new daughter now, but they're all happy with it. Nobody's upset by this, and the girl's name is Elizabeth. She's real passionate, she's real awesome, very, very delightful to be around, and she kind of breathes life into everybody, and they finally name the narrator as Victor, so we got a name for the guy who's actually narrating this entire thing. They decide in the end that they call each other cousin instead of brother and sister because she's been adopted, but more than sister is what he calls her, and he considers her to be his property, like she's his more than sister and nobody else's. And that was chapter one. Come on back for a summary on chapter two. See y'all later. Bye.